It's 5:45 in the morning, and I'm starting today's video at 5:45 in the morning because I am gonna make sure I get one out today. I think I've missed 3 video days that I should have been releasing a video, and I did not. One of the things I realized that I knew this was gonna happen. As soon as I missed one, missing 2 was gonna be much, much easier. Missing 3, even easier than that. And at some point you have to stop the slide and get back on the wagon and start holding yourself accountable again. So that's what I'm doing today. Today I want to talk about capacity because it's one of those KPIs that doesn't get a lot of attention. KPI stands for Key Performance Indicator, and these are numbers that tell you in a snapshot, they tell you an awful lot about your business. So when we talk about capacity, we're basically talking about how busy you are. How much work can you do if you were just all out, flat out, as hard as you could go, versus how much work you're doing now. And it's usually like a percentage. Are you at 70% capacity, or 80% capacity, or 100% capacity? So that's what we're gonna talk about. I'm gonna tell you why it's important for you to know that number. The interesting thing about capacity, like a lot of numbers, it doesn't tell you the whole story, but it tends to add a very critical piece to the story that's already being told. So for instance, I deal with a lot of service-based businesses. And if we run into a service-based business that's losing money, that in and of itself doesn't tell us a whole lot. If you're struggling with cash flow and you're at 85% capacity, then we typically have a pricing problem, a workflow process problem, but it's because the reason we're running into a cash flow crunch is because we're not running the business efficiently and effectively. If I go into another business, another service business, and they're struggling with cash flow and they're at 50% capacity, the answer is almost always overhead. You have staffed up, you've got way too much in payroll, you're running at 50% capacity because business has declined, or you just went on a hiring binge when you had no business doing it, or you invested in a salesperson who's costing you way too much money and isn't producing results. So in a service business capacity, it can shed some light on the other numbers and tell you what's behind, you know, what's the cause behind poor profitability or tight cash flow, those types of things. Let's say that you're not running a service-based business. So if you have one of these businesses that's meant to scale, but it's struggling with cash flow or profitability, and the capacity is low, it means you probably have not figured out your marketing channel yet. So you can see how those are two completely separate problems. In a service-based business, you're overstaffed typically, and when you've got low capacity utilization. When you're in a products-based business and you've got low capacity utilization, the problem is driving sales. So in one scenario, we're trying to cut costs, and the other scenario, cutting costs isn't gonna help us at all. We have to drive sales. If you've got high utilization numbers like 70, 80, 90%, you're running a products company and you're at high utilization, but your numbers still stink, you're either completely out of touch with your market and you have no idea what you should be charging, or you've got a competitor who's just trying to drive you into the ground with rock bottom pricing. I've seen that happen in 2 cases recently where we had incredibly high utilization. We're just getting pummeled on the income statement, and that's a hard situation to overcome. But apart from diagnosing like what might be happening with your numbers, why you're not as profitable as you want to be, or where cash flow is going. Utilization is a great way to anticipate the problems that are about to come your way. And it has to do with something that I heard about traffic one time. It was pretty interesting. So it turns out that the efficiency of any traffic system drops off a cliff when that system reaches 85% of its capacity. That's why you can have cars streaming down the interstate like 20 feet apart, virtually bumper to bumper, going 65, 70 miles an hour, and just a little bit of traffic, that little bit that pushes them past 85%, causes the entire interstate to back up for miles and miles and miles. There's no accident. There's nothing that's really gone wrong, or there's no cause for it. It's just that they've passed this threshold of 85% of maximum capacity, and the efficiency measured in the average speed of the cars on that road drops off like a cliff. You can still get more cars on the road, but they're vastly less efficient at getting to where they want to go. So if you're measuring capacity utilization on a regular basis, which I think is a smart thing to do, and there's some rules of thumb, there's all different ways to measure it depending on your business. But if you are measuring it on a regular basis and you see it creeping up to 80, 85, 87, 90%, understand that that's the point where systems will either break or things will start to become very, very inefficient. So like a good example is if your route people on your service route, if they're servicing air conditioners or they're servicing fire hydrants or they're servicing doing pest control, if they're doing lawns, if they are at 90% capacity and you have one cancellation, it wreaks havoc with the rest of the schedule, and they have a very hard time recovering from that. So one day may be horribly inefficient, and that's going to happen anytime you pass that 85% threshold. So just know it when you measure it. Maybe it's a time to start investing in extra capacity so that you can run efficiently somewhere in that 80 to 85% range. See you guys tomorrow. Bragging about Florida weather for a couple of months now because it's been absolutely gorgeous, and this is the time of year that everybody wants to come down here and live. That time is over.